those who've yet to find it, the places near where love is moving. Cast off the robes you're wearing, set aside the names that you've been given. May this place rest in the fold of your journey, bind you to hope. You will never walk alone.
In the shelter of each other, we will live, we will live.
Never walk alone.
In the shelter of each other, we will live, we will live.
I think the overall experience has been really great. A lot of great people, and it's just been good to grow closer together because Jesus built his church through people and through investing in the disciples. So it's been really good to invest in each other and to just be able to serve and just see the potential that where we can go beyond this 40 days to reach out.
Very fulfilling, very exciting to be part of a smaller group, to have that camaraderie, that caring aspect. Has been awesome. I'd encourage anybody that's not part of a small group to, you know, step outside maybe your comfort zone and get involved in it.
I found the book was very, very inspiring. It brought me back to reading the Bible. And I think the love of God is the most important thing to have in your heart at all times. The love that God gives you teaches you to love others, have patience with others. You listen to other people.
I learned there's so many different aspects to love that I didn't know about. Love is giving and it's patience and there's truthfulness in love. The lesson's full of aspects like that I've never thought of before. Could have taken the DVD home and went through it with Rick and myself, and I have my own thoughts, and I would have never accomplished what I have with my small group, and it's just been a huge blessing for me having a small group to go through our different thoughts and go through the lesson together, and I've just learned so much on love that I thought I knew it all, and it's been a huge motivation for me.
I will admit that sometimes I go to group and I'm not very happy because I'm tired and I want to go home. But we get there, we have a meal together, and people just are really encouraging, and it just makes my week better to know that you can come and share things and be real with people.
The last 40 days have, I would say, been quite meaningful for me, and being in the small group has also been good. I think the devotionals have reminded me again of especially things about the love of God and how much He loves us and the things that we can do for Him. In the ladies group, I think we've really shared quite deeply, and that's been very beneficial. And in the other group, I got to know the members of my small group much more, and I can see some of the value in that.
Helping me to get closer to the people in my group, and it's not so superficial, where you're not saying, well, hi, how are you, and you're saying, I'm fine, even when you have issues happening in your life, but it isn't appropriate to share. So the small groups give you that time to do that, where you actually share. It allows me and others to share their strengths and their weaknesses, and that only happens as being part of a small group. And it makes me see you and these specific people in a different way that I would never have gotten if I wasn't in those groups.
Small group is one of the things that I look forward to in my week because I don't always get to come on Sundays because of work. And so it's kind of a group that I need because it keeps me it forces me to be more intentional about getting into those people's lives, and I know it's really made a difference in my spiritual life. And so we also have a little singing time, and that worship time is one of the things that I look forward to the most.
What has impacted me the most with our small group has put a want and a desire to be together with the small group and on Sundays, kind of like a family reunion, which I have never experienced before, and what it truly means to be part of a family dynamic. And I'm learning how I fit, how I function, and how I really belong. And I enjoy the fact that I have a true sense of belonging in that family. I also have a very strong sense of no matter how tired I get, how frustrated I get, or even just beaten down, that I've got somebody to come alongside of me and to help me carry on, to keep running the race that I've been called to run, and that at some point I'll be able to do that for somebody else along the way.
And this has just really forced us to become more intentional about being deeper with each other and holding each other accountable and just really growing together and becoming more connected and serving together, and that's been really cool to be intentional with each other.
Better together portion has really kind of jump-started us to getting to know each other more and to being intentional about being in each other's lives.
And to be part of a smaller group to just encourage each other is really, really fulfilling. And oftentimes we get so busy in our lives that we're like, oh, I don't have time to be part of another thing. Well, you know what? You'd be surprised at how much time we actually have when you're doing something that you find that is really encouraging to others, but it's also encouraging.
A very positive and what I would feel a natural extension of my church experience, and that it allows a group of people to get together, to focus on each other, focus on God, and it has given us an opportunity to seek additional, more purposeful and important ways of communing and helping others. And I think that that's been a very positive overall experience.
It's been a great blessing to be part of a small group and get to know friends, people that I see in church all the time, but never know what's going on in their lives. And it's been really great to hear of their struggles and hear of the blessings that they're enjoying, but to be able to communicate with each other and pray for each other and feel part of a family, as opposed to just being people that pass each other in the hallway as Sunday morning in church.
No matter what you come up against, all the hurts in your life, God is there to take care of it and to take care of you. He loves you. I know He loves me.
Can you stop
it for a sec? She's gonna edit it anyway.
Preston, every week these jelly beans are full.
Every week when I leave here, I feel so full. That was a good one.
I like it.
I like it.
Into the world, showing how much He loves you. Walk in the world in merciful ways. He loves you. gives you.
I think the most important thing for me, or the thing that struck me as most meaningful, is that we've been challenged as a group to kind of look outside of ourselves a little bit and start meeting some needs within our own church and also within our communities, and also reaching out to people in our own circles.
The other side of it, I think, is the emphasis on being missional, the emphasis extending the family, moving the family in a direction that is more outward focused, and so I appreciate that. As well.
I found living in a condo is like a family, and my work has been learning from that study. My work has been growing in the condo with all the people. I have come closer to them. I have appreciated them. And I'm only too happy to show my love for the Lord.
Yeah. Has impacted your relationships, especially with those that are somehow difficult to deal with in the condo situation. And Betty has just found an added measure of patience and understanding, and able to listen to them and let them talk it out and just sit and listen. And she's learned a lot from that.
God is much more accessible than I thought. As far as finding people to help, you just have to look around and you're there.
We were encouraged to do in our small groups was to reach out to community people. And you know, one of the aspects that we've done that with is through Kids Club, starting a little program, a Kids Club. And it's so gratifying, it's so exciting to be able to connect with the parents and the guardians of the kids in Kids Club, and to just discuss life with them and just enjoy their company and just invite them to, you know, just be part of our, you know, our group, and just to befriend them and hopefully, you know, to reach out even further and to help them to even know Christ.
I think we're intended to be giving people and people who are serving needs in our own communities, and so I think it's been really good to be challenged as a small group to be doing that together.
These 40 days has been sharing stories and thinking of missional ideas that we hadn't thought of before and trying to pursue them.
40 days helped motivate me to go and visit someone in the hospital, and I probably wouldn't have done that if I hadn't had my fellow group members to go with. So it spurred me on to do something, and I'm glad that it.
Go into the world, showing.